Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with another high-performance Tyan Thunder HX server with a multi-character name that's far from memorable. This one is the B7122-T75V8E4HR-2T, and it's part of the TS75B7122 family of servers. Since there are only two, maybe not so much of a family as a potential family. This barebones system features third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors, 12 front hybrid drive bays, support for up to 8 terabytes of memory, and 2 double-wide GPUs or 4 single-wide. Let's take a look. This system is designed for AI inference and in-memory computing workloads. Not a bad platform for high-performance computing applications in general either, with support for GPU acceleration. I will mention that there is another system with a dash N on the end of that name. That would be the B7122-T75V8E4HR-2T. The difference between these two systems, the one with the dash N and ours without the dash N, is the power supply. The dash N version supports 1000 watt and 2000 watt 1+1 redundant PSUs, while our chassis only supports 1000 watt and 1000 watt PSUs. Both feature 80 plus platinum rated PSUs with 1+1 redundancy. And I think it's quite clear now why it was necessary to create an entirely different SKU for these platforms. I mean, that extra power is, what's the word I'm looking for? I don't know. Let's just move on. On the front of the system, both systems, by the way, there are 12 3.5-inch SATA drive trays with an option for installing up to 4 NVMe U.2 hot swap drives. The backplane supports SAS at 12 gigabits per second, SATA at 6 gigabits per second, and NVMe. So SAS compatible too with a discrete controller card. There are 2 OcuLink connectors for the NVMe drives and 3 mini SAS HD connectors. The drive bays are nicely color-coded, with those light blue bays for the NVMe drive formats, while the other can be SAS or SATA. SATA can also be installed in all bays. Virtual RAID on CPU, or VROC, is supported for those NVMe drives, providing limited RAID functionality. On the left of the server ear, there are 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, and in the right server ear, a small control panel with the usual cast of characters. Power on button, ID button, and reset button. Then LEDs for LAN 1 and LAN 2, ID LED, warning LED, and HDD LED. There are also status LEDs on the drive trays. Yes, we do have the Tyan Thunder TS75B7, the one with the dash 2T on the end, in stock right now. And for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system listed on our site, or one that you can configure at itcreations.com using our online configurator that adds up to $5,000 or more. Just click that link to see more information, and when you've made up your mind, just mention this video to save. Moving to the back of the system, there are 2 PSUs placed on opposite sides of the chassis. In between, there's a system ID button LED, a removable cover plate if you want to install an OCP 3.0 mezzanine card. The OCP card provides additional options for network connectivity and other different port configurations and connection speeds that won't detract from those main PCIe slots. OCPs are very much standard equipment at this point. However, OCP 3.0 is a significant improvement over OCP 2.0, offering more bandwidth with a x16 slot instead of a x8 slot. OCP 3.0 is also a lot easier to install by just removing the cover plate from the back of the chassis and sliding it in. Next, old school VGA port, LAN 2 and LAN 1 ports, featuring a 10 gigabit Ethernet network connection, and next to those, a dedicated 1 gigabit MLAN port for remote access to the system. Then 2 USB 3.0 ports, and above those, a bunch of cover plates for the PCI slots supported in 3 risers inside the chassis. Inside the chassis, you can see 4 separate risers in back, one of which supports 2 slots, and the others, just 1. In case I leave this part out at some point, all of the slots are PCI 4.0. There are 3 full-height, full-length PCI x16 slots with a x16 PCI connection, then 2 half-length slots, one of which has a x8 slot with a x8 PCI link, and the other with a x16 slot and x16 link. In addition to those, there is a x16 for the optional OCP 3.0 card, plus 2 more x4 slots on the system board that support NVMe M.2 storage devices. Those last can be rated using VROC. 2 SATA disk-on-module or SATA DOM slots are also on the system board, and they too can be used to support the OS. DOMs are very similar to M.2 drives with a solid-state circuit board. In other words, there are options for supporting your OS. I found the supported GPU section to be a little brief because it didn't really say how many were supported, nor specifically all the GPUs that have been vetted on this system. Definitely the RTX A5000 and A6000, plus the NVIDIA T4. Since there is an option for two additional 8-prong power cables for GPU support, I'm going to assume two double-wide GPUs. I'm going to assume a bunch of other double-wide cards since the TDP of that RTX A6000 card is 300 watts. The NVIDIA Tesla T4 only uses 75 watts of power, so potentially up to four of those cards can be installed since it is a half-height, half-length card, and we have the slots to support up to four. Probably the NVIDIA A2 as well, since it too is a half-height, half-length card with a TDP of only 60 watts. In a nutshell, you can probably install most GPUs on this system up to 300 watts in varying quantities. Although the other system, with the Dash N featuring a 2000 watt PSU, may be a better candidate for the double wide GPUs, given this one only supports the 1600 watt PSU. That said, if you place a 2000 watt PSU into our non-N system, will it now be converted to the next SKU? Or just return an error message? The RJ45 MLAN port on the back of the system is IPMI 2.0 compatible and provides access to the ASPEED AST2500 Baseboard Management Controller, or BMC. It features KVM over LAN support. Along with the third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors is support for a new management software offered by Tyan. Tyan's Server Management Plus 2.0, or just TSM Plus 2.0. TSM Plus allows administrators to access the system remotely to monitor and manage the system in band and out of band using a standard web browser. It's also suitable for multi-server management. You get status monitoring, asset management, and firmware update scheduling. It can also be configured to send out alerts and provide system logs. All the good stuff. It's like getting full-size candy bars in your Halloween goodies. Those third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors not only enable the new management software offered by Tyan, but they also provide PCI 4.0 for improved performance for I/O and NVMe storage devices. Not to mention GPU support, but also 8 memory channel architecture for a larger memory footprint. Each of the two CPU sockets has 16 memory module slots for a total of 32 active slots on the system board with both processors installed. Supported memory includes registered, load-reduced, and 3DS RDIMM and LRDIMM modules. 3DS memory modules offer greater density than standard RDIMM and LRDIMM modules and will provide the highest memory capacity at up to 8 terabytes. You'll only get 4 terabytes using standard RDIMM or LRDIMM modules. Memory speeds of 3200 megatransfers per second are supported with Platinum and Gold series CPUs and only up to 2933 megatransfers per second using Silver. Speed will also vary depending on the memory modules you install. For high performance computing tasks like AI, AI inference, and in-memory data analytics, the 2U Tyan Thunder HX-T5, this one, delivers the goods. Dual Intel Xeon Scalable processors with support for PCI 4.0, more memory at up to 8 terabytes supported by the 8 memory channel architecture, and hybrid storage options. Oh, and let's not forget support for high-performance PCIe GPU accelerators. Yep, if you want it, we've got it. Just click that link on the side or visit itcreations.com. If that isn't your cup of tea, then we've got a full selection of other Tyan servers to choose from, and we can custom configure to your specifications. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching. Oh, and before you leave, hit that subscribe button.